All right, we are back and we are continuing on. And McIntyre is going to go ahead and do Ravenloft. He's already started it, but he's only done the first three quests. That being said, he also needs to do a lot. He's done all of Threeborough Cove and he's done all of Sentinels of Stormreach, but only on either normal or hard. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to blitz the Sentinel or the Pirates of the Thundersea heroic arc as well. No, I did this with Batch, and you know, we all have their own ways. I find it most efficient just to go right.
These camps appear well organized, as if the crew expects to stay for a while.
Enjoy the moment, but don't let this distract you from the mission.
Yeah, I have a Morning Lord's weapon already. And I have a different Sentinel jewel.
Dinks, the first mate of the Bomb Bomb Raider, has fought his last battle. Gaia's orders say he's to sail on Stormreach, blockade the harbor, keep him from leaving the inlet.
The mission is going well. Perfect.
Which one do I have?
The mission is going well. I got a second. Which sentient jewel do I have in it? Oh, the Resolute. Okay, well, the Resolute gems that I've collected over on. I guess I'm gonna have to. The advantage is ours.
She's slightly less annoying than the Inquisitive. Slightly.
done.
Like I said, the point of this isn't to do anything amazing. We're just grinding out sagas because sagas give a far better renown per minute than, you know, quests. I could do.
Keep that up.
Like all of Ravenloft on Epic Normal solo, and get. Even if I got a legendary victory each time, for a lot more time I would have spend and only come out almost even. And I'm kind of getting to play some characters I haven't played in a while because they finished their Epic Destinies. Boom. And the pirate ship goes boom.
No mercy, no anger. Focus.
Actually, McIntyre would be kind of a little bit more than a little bit crazy because he'd be all like laughing at it, you know? I think like Mander Allen from after Durnick talked to him about facing his fear of the Mudmen. He'd be like riding into battle, like just like laughing. Hey, I never saw my paladin as a stick in the mud paladin. It's like whiskey is good. You know, as long as you don't get, you know, so drunk you forget who your god is, that's fine, you know. You know, when you drink enough, get drinking enough to get drunk enough to see your god, that's fine. When you go past that, you go into like the purple weasel stage, you've gone too far. Yellow. Garbage. See, Mac has the plus 5 Frost Great Club of Everbright. That's the good deal. Especially perfect for black pudding. Ah, I see. I probably prepped to do this and then didn't do it. That so seems like me. Like, I'm going to totally do this. Oh, shoe shiny. Alright. Legend of Two-Toed Tobias.
The Weeping Cove is rumored to be a resting place of Two-Toed Tobias, an ancient three-barrel legend.
That's right, full heavy armor, my swim skill is still like, it doesn't go down.
As you enter the cave.
Another target down, on to the next.
I thought Mac was my strongest character. I don't think he is anymore. I think 42 is now my strongest. It was 3C, but I TR'd him. But 3C didn't need to worry about the swim skill. He's a Warforge.
The valve triggers a rush of water through the pipes, followed by the sound of a door opening. Strong current pushes against you.
I'd say let's just go back and swim, but I do want the ad packs.
Trap! Remember to avoid the area.
All my sword does is nag, nag, nag.
You hear doors close ahead and behind you. You fear that you are trapped.
Oh no, I'm trapped.
Got one! Cervantes, Two-Toed Tobias' first mate, has been returned to the depths. I've done my part. Get out there and finish the job, soldier.
A slight breeze emerges from behind the wall.
I just want her to be quiet, so. We're gonna go with Skybreaker.
A ship's mast rises up from a chasm in the cave floor.
The novelty of the jewels talking back to you, I think, wears off pretty so quickly.
A frigid cold cuts through your body as you see a frozen river below. The source of the cold air is coming from this room. The fire jets melt the ice, allowing you to continue your search for two-toed Tobias.
Oh yeah, I was supposed to put on the outfit. We'll have to do that. Hey, something broke over here and gave us loot.
Second valve triggers another chain reaction, which opens the door to the rest of the dungeon.
Sorry, there's just too many good collectibles in here. Tier twos. Gotta get them while I can. Doesn't take that much time. Come on.
Levers appear on opposite sides of the room.
Coffin nail
with bullseyes.
Yeah.
As the lever flips back, the floor opens.
Probably should have been using Hunter Slayer in this quest. Like it really matters, I know. Actually.
The door before you opens as if you were expecting.
I could one-shot Garl.
The supposed urban legend speaks to you.
Two-toed Tobias.
The legend of two-toed Tobias was not just an urban myth, although it is doubtful that anyone would believe your tale. Resting place of two-toed Tobias, an ancient three-barrel legend.
I know, almost everything out here is undead, and that would have been just as useful, but... Really? Only two things? Geez, usually I have like five or six. A ruby of lesser acid. Woo. Truly my thimble runneth over. It seems like the last thing that scorpion ate was a kobold, judging by the contents of its stomach, containing an icon of Khyber.
Our cave extends deep into the rock behind this waterfall.
I'm always been a little bit disappointed that the sentient jewels were not allowed to be put on
the
Skybreaker. Protect the eggs.
The egg splits open, spilling rank smelling jelly into the water. One down, two dozen to go. Something glistens far beneath the stone bridge. Looks like a clutch of slimy eggs.
Oh, that was a nice save. He's got a really good jump skill too. I know he's 40. So I can make all the long jumps in the platforms.
A huge chief top, progenitor of the eggs.
Through the golden arches lies the way to
the
That's how bad of an American I am. Every time they say, through the arches, I think through the golden arches. Woohoo, burgers!
Cave extends deep into the rock behind this waterfall.
If I actually cared about the end rewards, I would go back and turn it in. But I don't, so I don't. I'm only grinding for saga rewards.
The feel of this place has changed. The air is strangely cold now, and the scent of old decay has replaced the troglodyte's musk.
So you use Hunter Slayer. Not for all things, because
the chill flows out from behind the falls, so strong that the water makes your feet numb and cold.
Yeah, I thought maybe I'd not aggro them, but not that lucky. Not the most exciting thing to do, but... Uh-oh, my phone went bleep bloop. Why is my phone going bleep bloop? Oh, well, that's good. I've got to do that later.
Unholy,
that was actually kind of important.
From the sarcophagi lining this corridor, Garl's wrath is corrupted. They must be destroyed.
I am wearing the Necro 4 armor that's got the haste guard.
And smells of spices and rot.
Smells of the spice girls and rot. Wait, what? Ah, that was a hard, hard cut.
The whispering voice speaks again. Go back, fool. Every step you take only hastens your doom.
Every step you take.
The air here is so cold that frost rots.
Every bond you break.
The chill seems to have come from beneath the water.
Really? Wow. I'm like full up on. I'm gems for some reason. Huh. I guess I will recall. I didn't plan to. Oh well.
The lock on the door here looks complex, but you might be able to open it with the proper key.
That was weird.
A chest gleams in the frozen light. This is Grey Garl's lost hoard. As the chest opens, a frigid wind sucks the last warmth out of the room. Old Grey Garl, with a despairing shriek, old Grey Garl dissolves like a pestilent vapor. The cold suffusing the air begins to fade. A cave extends deep into the rock behind.
You gotta go out there and see if I can get into Strinati's hand cannon, but what would be the point? That does look really good on Mac. Kind of makes him look like an old sea captain. Now Zathras gets his old armor. Zathras gets his old armor then. I think I'm going to keep this on Mac. He looks better in it.
Curiously alone in the center of the cove. The loathsome. The trial will be treacherous. Be aware of every step you take. Dismantled the rusty iron defenders. This is sure to be the first of many surprises. Intricate system of ladders leads up the shaft. Agility and physical endurance will be paramount in overcoming this challenge.
That's a big effect box for that grease. Having to make balance checks halfway up the shaft. Crazy.
muscles are warm and weird from the fetid stench of sewer fills your nostrils. You survived the warforged ambush. Now the constructs cease to exist. The floor opens up to reveal an elaborate obstacle course. One wrong step could put an end to the trial. A series of levers and traps dot the walls, the floor, and the ceiling. Only your wit can solve this conundrum. Pulling this lever fires a dart high above, leading you to believe it is a trigger mechanism. The other components in the room return to their initial state. This appears to be a reset mechanism.
One, two, one, two, one. No, that should have worked. Maybe I did it too fast. Oh, I went to the wrong one. That's what I did. I feel silly. I got a little backwards right there, didn't I?
Challenge was no match for your sharp wit. The portcullis rumbles open.
You hear a metallic clanking from behind, coming closer.
A sweltering wave of heat washes over your body. Rackham's inferno will take precision and cunning to overcome.
No, well. I got a draconic soul gem, a lot of natural resistances. Shoot me!
You have weathered Rackham's inferno. A few burns and sweat coat your skin.
Zance, first mate of the ill fate, motions for you to come over and speak with him.
Hmm.
survive the grooms of Rackham's tribe.
I actually had one time where Meeble actually defeated, I stayed long enough and Meeble defeated all the dogs. So, you're all like, yeah!
A small building stands
curiously alone. I was all like, yeah, you go, Meeble.
Center of the cove. Is drawn into an opening in the rock just large enough to wiggle through. A thick fog rises up from the water as voices of pirates float along the current. Moonlight shines down from an opening above. The entryway into the pirate's compound rumbles open. A strong breeze gusts from a crack in this wall. Suddenly the clanking of wood and metal intensifies. Ring of Warforged, one spring.
For some reason, my gamepad just decided to jump off my desk. Just totally committed suicide. Stupid gun. There's no real reason for it. Don't know why. Just jumped off.
Anything. One wrong move could kill me. Please, speak with me first.
I'm pretty good at the puzzle, but I think it's going to just be quicker if I just go back here and kill the guy.
A voice calls out from the back of the room. Please, the captain bellows. You defeated the captain and ended his illegal smuggling operation.
I have to kill everybody to get there. I don't want it. Fine. Whatever. Whatevs. That's a chance to do something a little different.
The current is drawn into an opening in the rock just large enough to wiggle through.
Thank you. Where is the Morning Lords?
Good. The more you give me, the greater the glory.
All right. Now we should just have Sentinels of Stormreach. Yep. Now, another part of Sentinels of Stormreach is that first quest is all the way out in the Searing Heights. Which is good if you're doing it from an everyday point of view, but when you're in like full, I gotta get it done mode, kind of resent it a little bit. Oh, 1 second. You're fine, you're fine. The camera's now facing more this way than it is that way. Bark soup here. That bitter cold. That's good. That's the way it's best. Yeah, when it's so cold, I get that first sip hiccup. That's good. first mate over there? Nope. Then we're just going to jump. Oh, whoa. Jump off. Not slide off. I want to be an airborne ranger. Never mind, I thought I was seeing something that I really wasn't. Ha 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 ha. Just wanted to make sure I was doing it on the right way. Murder pirates. I forgot to do something, I know. This lever. Annoy me with your little bows and arrows, that's one thing. This lever opens the bottom gate, so it's not that necessary. Thank you. I'm gonna check something right quick. No? Oh, I bet you he's doing it. Yeah, let's do it this way. Yeah. I'll never understand that. Now, where the bargain bazaar, you can just blister everything and not have to do much. Here, you kind of have to do everything. Sorry, I'm still a little kind of hungry. One of the best things about living in California. Pistachios, I got these for $3.50 a pound. Good.
Ready yourself for the upcoming battle against the necromancers and the undead pirate minions. These guards look and smell like zombies. Their quick and decisive movements suggest that these are no ordinary undead.
It's tarp. I'll kill you later. Something worse. I liked the narration on these. He kind of had a... I think he did another one, but he was perfect for Sentinels of Stormreach. Adventurer, use your key now. Roar.
Here you can see nothing moving on the pirate ship below. It appears to be completely deserted.
I'm not gonna come back for the treasure. Just not any of these quests I want. Yeah, I might still play later on. I won't be streaming it because, what time? 3, 4, 5, 6. I plan to watch McVegan Pants' show. Made a paste.
As you wonder whether the ship is still empty, you hear a shout.
Can I eat the paste? In the tendency of draw wizards, this is one of the few end quests I always thought that actually kind of end fights that kind of need to be harder.
No sign of concern about what awaits him. He simply stares blankly ahead as his body falls lifeless to the ground.
There's where it is. I never knew. I never use it because it's like in the middle of the water, so the lag is super bad, but nice to know where it's at just in case of emergency. And a couple of times we really could have used it early on when we didn't know what we were doing, but that's not a hard fight anymore. Actually, of all the end fights and all these quests, I'd have to say it's probably the easiest. Think about red alerting the entire next quest. This is really the only way to get to the top, and I don't really want to fight everything.
Outraged hoots and grunts echo through the ravine. This ground is sacred to the island's native wildlife.
I'm not going to kill everything. Unless it makes me. All right, run up, swing the sword. Apparently, I'm gonna kill everything but one wild man. Go away from me, dogs.
The blood-tied fortress lies beneath.
Usually, there's a shaman up there. Kobolds. Human Murderer 5. I'm kind of just done with them. Let's go. Go, 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 go. Faster, faster, faster. Destroy the ballistas. Three, two, one. Yeah, that makes sense. This is really easy on my artificers because they just sit on the top and just shoot the ballistas and jump down. You mean I'm not facing the lever? Usually when I'm doing it completely, all of those pirates are usually the last of the kill more pirates. Want to beam up. Green, nope. Just take it. Yeah, apparently I'm off cycle.
As you enter, you are surprised to hear the clamor of battle, the cries of the wounded. The tower is being attacked from the inside.
Try to do this as fast as I can. If they can follow me, I'll kill them. This is where we keep all of our best plus one weapons. Stupid wafting stench.
The rats down below pay the filth no mind.
You say, no, I was under that. I figure out why I'm getting this. I only had that one character, one section where I kind of skipped. I killed most of them. The only thing that was left was a... Oh, wait, no. Yeah, okay, I get it. Never mind. You're obviously counting all the stuff on the bottom now, too. Oh, obviously trying to make it harder for me. This is a weird thing where you had to kill these guys. These guys you had to kill. You could literally run by everybody but those six creatures. Crazy. I could have got them all. I would have done the optionals to get the rares, but
the tower's exterior teems with pirates screaming for your blood. The infamous Crimson Moon, the flagship of Captain Tew's fleet, fills the sky with menace. If you could destroy the airship, then the pirates would be stranded in the tower.
Thank you. Now the Crimson Moon is destroyed, I can finally get the Captain Q. Oh, there's Leonard Winter's Wrath. Full Siberia's Dragon Shard, I will take that though. We'll go back to a three-bow code real quick and turn in the Sega. Another 60,000 gilder now. Nope. Bloop. Look at that. I got a big bleep bloop. Hmm. All right. Barkeep. I'm gonna throw away all this except this, which is good because it's a clicky. Banker. Throw away the Winter's Wrath. That is garbage. Panning out anymore. All right. Let's move this real quick. That way I can see it. I don't really need to see me.
You stumble through the thick mists. You spot a corpse in the grass near the abandoned cot. From down the road, you hear the sounds of harsh growls and clapping. The soldier looks up at you, his face strangely pale.
Halt! Do you serve Strahd?
You hear howling.
Do I serve Strahd?
A raven cries somewhere.
I don't even know what kind of dish that is.
Scarecrows to guard a road in the middle of the forest. What do they stop them to keep an eye on? You hear a branch snap behind you. To the ground. As you recover, you realize you can hear noise from up the road to the east, the same way you hear.
Maybe the scarecrows aren't popping for some reason. Do I have... Nope, just bugged out. I guess. Oh. XP doesn't really do me any good. I have completed all of my epic destinies. Death House. On my paladin, which should not be that much different than on my barbarian, to be honest with you. And be perfectly honest with you. No big thing.
Small, distant voices spring from nowhere. We're so hungry. Find us.
You're dead. How can you be hungry?
Here we are. You spot something in the middle of the room. Something small and old and forgotten.
We're tired. Been here so long. We want to rest. Take us to a nice place to rest. We're tired. We want to rest now. You found the secret door. It leads down to the basement, where the monster is.
Beyond the secret door, a dusty stairwell leads down into darkness.
Squish.
You gently place the bones inside the coffins.
Much better.
The distant voice seems pleased.
We can rest here. Once you get rid of the monster in the basement.
On top of the desk, you find a tarnished key.
I remember having true seeing, but apparently I do. And that's just fine with me. I'm not going to spend a lot of time searching for doors. I don't know where that zombie came from. That's great, though. I got all sliced up.
chanting echoes from down the hallway. Robed apparitions surround the altar, chanting. He is the ancient. He is the one. The ghostly chant suddenly changes. One must die. One must die. Norgoth the Decayer, we awaken thee. The robed figures vanish, and something stirs in the water.
From there, I thought I'd actually got it.
A little voice in the darkness says,
you got rid of the monster. Good. Time to sleep. Good night.
There's a sudden gust of air, as if the entire building let loose a sigh.
A sigh? I thought this was like gothic Europe, not like medieval Japan. I need it for surgery too. I was thinking I was gonna. There's a rare right here. Or an incident, I suppose. Not a really rare, because I didn't get a rare red name, but there's chess, so I'll take it.
Voices, ragged and carping, come from the other side of the window. Peasants with joyless faces and vacant eyes wait in a line. An indistinct
plus 47.
The sight of an outsider.
Plus 36.
The rest of these
plus 43.
To me. They stare sullenly.
Yeah, I think I can handle it.
A wolf howls in the distance. Its cry echoed first here, then there. The wind whispers treacherously among the upper boughs. This corpse is nearly beyond recognition, so savagely has it been mangled by wolves.
Stop moving so I can kill you!
Those are not pebbles filling the air between the megaliths. They are human teeth.
It slices, it dices, it makes julienne fries.
so, then the women of the windmill are not what they appear to be, nor are their pies.
Nope.
Morgantha addresses the gathered peasants from up on the wooden platform.
Be off already! Shoot!
She says.
We've no more pies. How many times must I tell you?
Morgantha looks down at you.
You poor misguided soul. You thought that they did not know?
Morgantha howls.
Enough of this. Kill them, and you'll feast on outsider pies tonight.
That's the last of them. Now, for the pie makers within the window. Mad Patrick comes from upstairs as a dredge comes, fully forward, out of the bubbling, tarry counties of a cauldron.
Gee, sometimes it sure seems like the hags are speaking Simlish.
Her is cut down before her. The hag Morgantha flees the windmill. All of this, as the oil spreads across the floor and then catches up on the hill ahead, Morgantha performs a prayer for aid, and then something answers.
Something. Well, then get the armor. I always want the armor out of this one. So it looks pretty much like this, only brown and a little bit longer. Got a some pauldron type things, more robey. It's like a duster rather than a pea coat. That's actually a really good way of putting that. Colorless, nothing. All right. Now this isn't a big deal on the pally. He's got remove curse, he's got his death ward. I have death ward. But really, in all honesty, the key thing of course is always to have the remove curse when fighting the hate shadows. All right, deal that deck, lady. Wow, that's going to be hard. Wow. They are not going to make this easy on me today. And I gotta go right by it. Wow. This has gotta be the worst draw I have ever had. Madam Eva does not like Captain Heath McIntyre. Oh, you a foolio.
Step into the dining hall.
Shadow damage.
The stern, regal man turns to face him.
Please, come in, my honorable princess. I am, of course, Count Strahd von Sarkovich. Strahd's laughter echoes across the hall, and his form dissolves into mist. The door slams shut. It's a trap.
It's a tarp. We'll go up and we'll see what the where the ally is. I'll bet you it's in the upper servants' quarters. Huh? Maybe we gotta take that. That cake is a lie.
You have found an ally within range.
Called it. Boom. Everything but her is in the cellars. Crazy. Not too sure. Two. One. Cellars. I got lockpicks.
You have found the keystone. The icon of Ravenloft awaits discovery somewhere within the castle.
Alistair is always disappointed that the keystone is not a really bad beer.
Strahd stands here. Gazing into the distance. As you approach, he speaks. I hope you found exploring the castle stimulating. The worthy learned to call it home. An intricately carved brazier lights this space, with a flame that seems to give off no heat. Metal statues regard the flame from either side of the room. In a flash of fire, you are teleported. There is a spiral staircase across the room, suggesting you are in one of the castle towers. A great rumbling shakes the floor, coming from below. When you open the iron chest, a silver statue tumbles out and lands on the cold stone floor. It is the icon of Ravenloft. A sense of peace washes over you. As you hold the icon of Ravenloft in your hands and stow it securely in
I got the main entrance.
Now that you have the icon and the keystone, it's time to go. You recall that Esmeralda said your only way out is through the main entrance. You should head there when you're ready. Just as the way out comes into sight, you sense movement. Strahd isn't done with you yet.
Yeah, I got the dragons. Ooh, more dragons. Tasty, tasty dragons. Come on, come on, come on, come on. More dragons. More dragons.
With the keystone in hand, you
no more dragons.
The castle wards unhindered.
Aww.
You check your bags. Sure enough, the icon of Ravenloft is still there. You have done it.
Tasty, tasty dragons.
Wonder if you will cross paths with Esmeralda again.
That was just kind of fun to do something different finally. I've been out everywhere else except for the main entrance, and now I gotta fight the dragons. Green. Looking for green augment slots. Now, any metal? Nope. Impressive trophy. Warhammers I kind of need with the red augment slots. Metal or not, I trade all mine over to equip Nora. So we're kind of getting the feel, so I guess I got about 40 more minutes to complete this. I'm in the middle of that. All right, no problem. Hoganoff's fault.
The mansion looks abandoned, Yet according to what you've been told, the Order of the Silver Dragon still guards this place, bound by an oath that not even death can break.
But what about an angry Scotsman? Keep forgetting there's nothing over there except revenants. I mean, it's not like that they're super hard to kill or anything, but... it's a question of what needs to be done. That was weird.
Surprise, the figure is revealed to be a wounded Dusk Elf. A fire erupts in the dead hearth. A voice whispers, "My knights have fallen into darkness. Show them that they are lost."
I didn't really need to move that one. Silly me. Oh, this is the way. Do you know the way so to San Jose? Do 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 do.
Slumped in the throne is a gaunt, armored figure. Without looking up, it says simply,
"Go away."
The revenant shakes his head.
Argenvost's light has vanished. Speaking will never shine again. All that is left is Strahd's endless punishment. And I will destroy anyone who tries to end his torment.
The revenant falls, once again nothing more than a lifeless corpse. On the commander's body, you find a large silver key. Engraved on the key is the name Argenvost.
He's just a quitter.
A quitting quitter. It's good that we cut him down. He not only serves Strahd, he serves Strahd supreme. And boy, does that look funny when you take Strahd and cover him with tomatoes and sour cream.
Is a fog-shrouded cemetery. An impressive mausoleum stands in one corner. Gate is the name Argenbost. You use the silver key you found on the commander, and the outer gate to Argenbost's mausoleum opens. You place Argenbost's skull inside the mausoleum, and a brilliant light fills the room. Now, if there were only some way to direct the light to the beacon atop the mansion.
Like these mirrors? I might be confused here.
Just beyond the closed door. Your eye is drawn to the impressive beacon that dominates the courtyard. Suddenly, taloned creatures fly out from behind it, swooping down on their prey.
Now, if it's paralyzed, it should fall to the ground like a lead rock. Come on.
Seen throughout the valley, and from somewhere a voice whispers,
"The best defense."
From its vows. You feel a tingle of warmth that you have never felt in Barovia before.
I forgot what a great generalist McIntyre is. He's not my best one. That would definitely be Ziggy Star, but he's real close. I think this one is next. I think this is 2-2.
You have returned to Castle Ravenloft, this time uninvited. As promised, the servant's door was not sealed. A sign that Jesper the Raven made it this far, at least.
Yeah, read all the entries.
Whisper's last report says he went off to steal a potion from a coven of witches whose lair is at the top of the South Tower. This is the South Tower stair. Following it all the way to the top should get you close to the lair of the old crones mentioned in Jesper's journal.
Death! They need to invest in some elevators around here, like in House Caneth. Come on.
As you come to the door of the witch's den, you recall the password from Jesper's journal. You whisper, and the words on the door fade.
Gotta take care of the automatic cutlery.
Many sets of green eyes shine at you from the darkness. They regard you with a haughty aloofness that only one creature across the many plains has truly missed. The withered forms of two hags glare at you from across their cauldron. One of them, the taller of the two, gestures for you to speak with her. The old witches cackle, then one of them sneers at you.
We know about your little bandits. Baba Lysaga warned us of their spying ways. So they send a threat. Just like that, in he flew.
Face twisting into a gap-toothed grin, the witch continues.
You little bird flatters now in the dungeons with our enemies. Soon, all its secrets will be out, and then we'll feast. Her gaze lingers on you, and she licks her lips. Such a little baby, though, sister. I think we need more meat for our pot, don't you?
The cauldron's fiery heat abates. These vile crones have uttered their last curses. It is time to search their lair. You find a set of vials, which must be the potions of gaseous form described in the journal. They will allow you entry into the magical tower within the treasury.
Thank you.
broken furnishings lie scattered about the room. At the center of the destruction is the smashed remains of a moldering kiln. Its sickly sweet smell permeates the wreckage.
I don't have a dedicated smiter. Nope.
You quaff the witch's brew, and you watch as your body evaporates into a fine mist. By strength of will alone, you push yourself through the tiny tower window and take solid form again on the inside. The tower seems to be bigger on the inside somehow. Is filled with treasure. The thud of heavy footsteps coming from above serves as a warning that it does not lack for guards. This book's pages are brittle with age, and much of it is illegible. But what you can make out suggests the author is none other than Strahd himself. Perhaps your allies back in town can make sense of it.
None of these look any good. Tea time. Again, but this time I have mad fat trapping skills. So since I have mad fat trapping skills, I'm going to do it the right way, the complete way, the total way.
Are plotting each other's demise. Can you afford to side with the lesser evil? And if so, can you tell which one that is?
Do I need full restoration? I can use unyielding sovereignty. All right, never mind. Gives me the blue key, it means the blue key is no longer in that room.
According to Lady Fiona Vachter, this secret passage leads straight to the Baron's manor across the way.
Why is Fiona Walker's and the Baron's houses connected? Are they, like, entertaining each other while trying to betray each other? I guess it's my own channel. I guess I could just say where they hate
this
fucking?
This must be the dungeon under the Baron's manor. It appears he has already taken a couple of prisoners.
This Barovia place is super creepy.
A harsh commanding voice issues from down the hall on the left and reverberates throughout the Baron's manor.
You destroyed the flesh of his deformed arm melting away. One of my remove poison pots. Once the news is known. Oh man. I wish I could res you all so I could kill you again. Now our rangers need to get that. A real trap, a real immobilization trap. I'd go back to playing a pure ranger if we got that at 16. Silver key, silver key. Silver key. Thief? I haven't stole anything yet. Except all your guards' lives. It's just the dolls.
The note nailed to the doorframe defiantly reads, "All is not well." As you read it, you hear an odd noise behind this door. The hum and crackle of lightning. And a stifled gasp.
My dad will have your head on a pike. No, you misunderstood. I've been here to sent here to kill your dad by Captain Pike. Gave me the day off from Star Trek to do so.
No, of course it didn't.
Iron key.
Suddenly, a woman screams. Then the screen
red key. Got all the keys now. Let's go back. You have to go through the thing because I found that out. I just can't teleport back. Actually, I'll make the mission incompletable if I do that.
Fiona Vachter cannot contain her smile. Let's blame the child of truancy. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a bad intercourse and I'm not a good sick in the time.
I wanna kill an infernal ranger. And I got to, too. Somebody's after me. But they're not going to catch me. In here, except murder.
This gentleman is resting, impeccably dressed with two coins upon his eyelids. While he hasn't drawn a breath in years, a spell kept the chest is filled with human bones. An adult alchemical paraphernalia on these shelves hammer your senses with a bouquet of pungent, sordid odors.
It's fun to watch the effect go off and heal them sometimes, you know, just like, you know, it's like, yeah, I kind of wanted to extend the beat down.
A young woman's voice pleads from behind. The young woman hisses as she jumps onto her bed. Little kitty doesn't know you. Little kitty doesn't like your smell.
Really? You know what? I'm sorry. I want the chest now. Oh, I'll use my last Albus. That's a good idea. I really thought unyielding sovereignty was going to work. It removes all conditions. I guess maybe I should check to see if I had regular restoration, but I don't. Yeah, tier 4, I'm not wasting.
The evidence is plain as day, and so very damning that even the town of Alaki would shun her, were it known. Lady Vakta does a double take.
Oh, you! You made it this far? Pretty.
Funny is that thing is, I'm not really still too sure what her plan was. Ooh, a silver flame emerald, yay! I wonder if that takes care of my obligation. I don't know. So I have just enough time to do Sealed in Amber if I get a good roll. Oh. Oh shit, I was hoping to find. I was hoping to put the thing into the bank so I wouldn't have to worry about it. But it's just an Albus, it's not like it's a Garrett. Switch over to the Amber project page, which means I won't be watching the stream, but I'll be watching chat through the other app. Okay, I know where this is, and I need all of them. I don't. Sorry, I have a bit of an itch. Oh, this is where the Merak would have been. Never mind. The next one already. By the way, I cannot evade in heavy armor. So now which one's Aethernia? Merak, I just got Aethernia. I need Maverus. They're undead, Will-O-Wisp. Huh. Well, I've actually been the quickest I've ever done it. Wrong one, I need to go upstairs. It's a similar room. What? Oh. Sure do wish I could evade in heavy armor.
Found the symbol of Ravenkind. Surely it will be useful in the struggle to start.
She went through the teleporter. That's funny. It's great. I love it. Yep, missed it. Jeez, these things are persistent. It's too many of the bloody things in the quest. Never give me any information on the vestige, but usually it's in one of these two places over here. Sometimes you need to get it, because sometimes, well, this quest actually puts the symbol of Ravenloft inside of what's-her-name's chamber. I thought all I needed was to have the odd necklace. Oh, no, you've got to go to this sarcophagus, right?
This is the sarcophagus of Zudu that Casimir was searching for. You call out to him, and moments later, he arrives.
Mm-hmm. I can't remember if Miss if McVegan Pants said she was going to stream today. Yes! Bang! Coat of the Traveler. Perfect for any of my most of my mid-level tunes. All right, Sir J's got a bit of Alma. All right. Well, it is time to sup. I know I got four more quests, but I do need to get some food, and I think now is a good time to part ways for the night. I thank for everybody who joined me in the afternoon, and if you're watching this on the replay, nonetheless, whenever you see it, peace and good questing.